Hey guys, Jessica Swarbrick here with Strand Hill, and I'm here with Dan O'Connor.
Hi guys.
Thanks for being here, Dan. So me and Dan are going to sit down every week and discuss a hot topic that's going on in real estate, whether it be local or at the state level. And so this week we are talking about SB 9, which is Senate Bill number 9. This one was just passed on Thursday. Newsom signed off on it. And this will affect real estate. And so we're going to kind of go over it and touch on some of the main points. So SB 9, what it does, right now zoning in the state is different per city. So in Manhattan Beach, as you know, there's zones for every parcel. So there's R1, R2, R3, and that single family, duplexes, triplexes, 4, and it goes up. Right now, whatever you take down, you have to put back up. And on the flip side, whatever you take down, you can only put that same thing back up. So if you buy a single family home and a builder tears it down, they can only put up a single family home. They can't buy a single family and put up 3 apartment buildings. What this does is it would allow an owner to split their lot in two, creating 2 parcels, and on each parcel, they could put 2 units. So essentially one single family lot would then turn into the potential to have 4 units.
Yeah, it's quite a game changer.
Yeah.
It's basically applies to the R1 zoning,
mm-hmm.
and basically allowing people to not only build a single family, but up to 2 structures that could both be duplexes.
Mm-hmm.
And then there is allowance for in the duplex to also have a JADU. So you could have up to 6 units where one house used to stand.
Right.
Yeah.
So the idea behind this bill is that there is a housing shortage in California. We all know that. And especially affordable housing.
They're on a mission to create like 3.5 million new residences in the state of California.
Yeah. Okay, so now breaking this down, without getting into it too much, again, this was just passed on Thursday. I called the city last week when it was passed, and what the city had mentioned to me is that they have their legal team that then goes through the whole bill, because these bills are written so crazy and there's so much legal stuff in it. City's legal team goes through that, they kind of summarize everything and then pass it out to the city, and then the city gets it to us, so that we can kind of break it down more.
And
but,
the rule goes in effect January 1st.
Yeah, of next year,
right.
Of 2022. So this will go into effect, which is like literally 3 months away,
soon.
Really
yeah.
soon.
Yeah.
So some of the criteria for this is that each lot has to be 1,200 square feet, which again, that's not big when you consider—
Each new lot.
Each
right.
new lot, right. When you consider like—
The original lot has to be at least 2,400.
Yeah, when you consider East Manhattan is 7,500, that's not a problem. Even the lots that are 5,000 square feet, you could do the same thing. You had mentioned the lots have to be owned out, right?
Yeah, I believe one of the stipulations in there is that there can't be any debt on the property.
Mm-hmm.
So this does, in theory, kind of rule out your kind of mom and pop people that, you know, owe some money on the property, may have owned it for a long time.
Right.
And then there's the whole, you know, not only do you have to pay down any debt you have, then obviously you have to be able to afford to build. So
right.
it makes it not the most obtainable thing for the average person, I would say.
I agree with that. I mean, I think it's geared more to builders.
Developers,
yeah, that would then be buying lots. Some of the disputes to this, of course, there's a lot of disputes, knowing that you could be buying an $8 million home in the Hill section and potentially have someone tear down next door and pull up multiple units. But with this, you know, it's not necessarily creating more affordable housing. When you think of like the South Bay, how expensive things are here, even if you were to put up 4 units on what would normally be an $7 or $8 million home, and you divide that by 4, is $2 million a home really affordable? And then the other thing is, it's not actually allotting a certain amount of homes to be built. Like how you mentioned, the goal is to build a certain amount of homes. This isn't actually building homes, it's just allowing people to build more if they want.
Yeah, and I think there's a lot of commentary on the reality of how many residences this is really going to add to that 3.5 million goal.
Right.
They think, if I'm remembering correctly, there's like 600,000 or 700,000 lots that even really qualify.
Mm-hmm.
And then the reality of, you know, how many of those are really going to take advantage of this?
Mm-hmm.
Probably a fraction. So is this really helping the ultimate goal? I guess it's yet to be seen.
Right.
Yeah.
And then a third one with that is parking. Right now, you know, when a developer builds, they have to allot so many parking spots for whatever they're building. And in this case, that would not be the case. So obviously people would be worried about, okay, now if there's four or even six units in what used to be a single family home, is there going to be parking for people? And their idea with this bill is that hopefully in the future things go more green. There's more Uber, more people working from home. Maybe not as many people have cars. Who knows? We live in the South Bay and everybody has multiple cars here.
Yeah.
For how small it is. There's a lot kind of to be determined, but we just wanted to sit down and touch on this since I think a lot of people do have questions. It just passed Thursday and it is a very big thing that can affect real estate.
Yeah, there's SB9, which we're talking about.
Yes.
SB10 was also passed.
Yes.
Which is another high density type of housing law. We're not going to get into that today, but I think we both feel like a lot of people are not aware that these laws were even up for discussion, let alone passed. I know, again, in a future video, we're going to talk about the law that was passed over a year and a half ago about the number of units on a property that are
mm-hmm.
currently existing and how you can't reduce the number of units.
Mm-hmm.
That caught a lot of people by surprise, and in the 18 months it's been in
effect.
In place,
yeah.
Yeah, it's caused a lot of havoc, especially in Hermosa Beach, where the Coastal Commission is overseeing part of the city. It's affected people's land value, and not necessarily in a good way. So I think we both just felt compelled, but you know, really you deserve the credit for kind of bringing this more to light. It's something that's come up in our office. We have a couple people in our office that are very in tune and are talking with people that come in their open houses.
Yeah.
And the general public just doesn't seem to be aware.
Yeah, I agree with that. And so, like I said, this is something that we plan to do every week. It's our way of just getting information out to you guys. You know, watch the videos or don't, pass them along. We appreciate that. But, you know, we're here to help and we're here to educate people on real estate. That's our job. And so this is why we're doing these videos, to help educate you guys. There's a lot going on right now. And so we would love to hear your comments. And if you have questions on this, feel free to shoot them over. And until next week when we do our next video.